Welcome to the Best Coast Shire Council Report, your weekly update on council news and events.
Hi, I'm Steve Fury.
And I'm Christian Stephanie.
And welcome to this week's show where we'll be talking about Amendment C140, which is also known as the Rural Land Use Strategy, also how you can take part in the upcoming community engagement session in Cowes, and standing for council in the upcoming elections. But first up, kids are going back to school this week, Christian, which means school crossings are back in action.
That's right, Steve. Our council and Victoria Police are urging community members and parents to be safe when driving around schools in Bass Coast. With the local children returning to school this week, this is a reminder to all drivers to pay special attention around schools during drop-off and pick-up times. Drivers are reminded that when approaching school crossings, they should slow down to 40 kilometres or less, watch for the children, and remember not to stop too close to the crossing. Please don't forget that the crossing must be completely vacated of all pedestrians before proceeding.
Now, it's also really important for crossing supervisors to have a clear field of vision in both directions or all directions around the crossing so they can see approaching children and all vehicles. Because children are often very small, cars that are parked or stopped too close to crossings can completely hide them from the view of the supervisors and drivers. So couple this with children's limited ability to see danger can create a really hazardous situation.
Council and Victoria Police will be monitoring the crossings and driver behaviour generally around schools in coming weeks to promote safer behaviour around the schools, especially during drop-offs and pick-up times. So keep an eye out. Council has received the Planning Panel report for Amendment C140, recommending Council adopts the exhibited amendment with some changes. In early April, an independent planning panel considered submissions to Amendment C140, which seeks to implement the findings of the Rural Land Use Strategy and the review of the Real Wetland. The Amendment C140 panel report will now be considered at the Ordinary Council meeting on 17th of August this year.
The planning panel actually said the process around Amendment C140 was pretty good and complimented Council's responsiveness to the community submissions. It concluded that the Rural Land Use Strategy and the Amendment C140 have been through quite a good consultation process, and as a result of the hearing process, a number of changes have been proposed by Council in response to those.
There are a few changes recommended by the panel. Most notably, the proposed Rural Activity Zone not be applied to the majority of land at the Gerties. This recommendation is responding to community submissions regarding the environmental qualities of the Gerties area, and it's been recommended that the land remain in the farming zone until further environmental investigations have been done.
The report is available on Council's website at basscoast.vic.gov.au/C140 and at any of Council's customer service centres. For more information, please contact Council's strategic planning team on the numbers at the end of the show.
Thanks, Steve. Now the July Ordinary Council meeting is fast approaching, but beforehand, Council is holding an additional community engagement session in Cowes on Wednesday the 20th of July. The session is going to run from 1:00 p.m. until 3:00 p.m. at the Cowes Cultural Centre and is a chance for community members to discuss business currently before Council, such as a matter that has or likely to come before Council for consideration.
If you'd like to come along and speak with Council, we encourage you to register by providing details of the business you want to talk about and at least 24 hours beforehand, as this allows Council's time to prepare for the session and have responses ready for specific questions if required. Obviously, we don't have all of the answers on hand, so it gives them time to do a bit of research. The session's open to the public, so if you'd like to come along and sit in the gallery and listen without asking questions, of course, you're more than welcome.
Don't forget the July Council meeting will follow the engagement session at the Cowes Cultural Centre beginning at 5:00 p.m. At the beginning of this meeting, there's an opportunity for you to ask questions of Council during community question time. Questions must be submitted in writing prior to the meeting and responses will be published in the minutes. For more details on the engagement session and the question time, or if you'd like to see what's on the agenda for the July meeting, please visit our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au/meetings.
Another reminder that the local government elections are happening this year on the 22nd of October. Now, becoming a councillor is a great chance to influence the future direction of your local community. So if you're over 18 and you're on the electoral roll for the council area, then the chances are you'll be eligible to stand. If you're thinking about running or even just a little bit interested in learning more, the Stand for Council events in August are just the thing for you.
The first session will be on Monday the 22nd of August at the Grantville Transaction Centre, then Tuesday the 23rd at the Cowes Cultural Centre, and the last session is at the Civic Centre Council Chamber in Wonthaggi on Thursday the 25th of August. All these sessions run from 7 p.m. to 9 p.m. And if you need more information, contact us on the numbers at the end of the show or visit the campaign website standforcouncil.com.au.
Thanks, Christian, and that's it for this week. But as always, if you have any questions or need more information about anything we've mentioned, give us a call on 1300 BCOAST. That's 1300 226 278, or 0356 71221. You can also keep up to date on facebook.com/bass. Coast Shire, or follow us on Twitter at our handle at Bass Coast, and we'll catch you next week for more council news.
The Bass Coast Shire Council Report is broadcast on Tuesday mornings at 9:30, Thursday afternoons at 4:30, and on Saturday mornings at 10 on your community station 3MFM. Audio and transcript is also available from our website, basscoast.vic.gov.au.